It's one of the most profound questions of all. How did life on Earth begin?
Early on when I got into science, I decided that I'd like to work on a big question, a question that would be interesting all of my life. And the more I thought about original life, the more I thought, this really fits the bill.
With support from the National Science Foundation, Georgia Tech biochemist Nicholas Hud and a team at the Center for Chemical Evolution are working to chip away at the question. They are homing in on how chain-like chemicals called polymers first came together and evolved 3.5 to 4 billion years ago.
And we're thinking that on the early Earth, the molecules that gave rise to the first polymers of life, RNA and DNA, would have actually started by small molecules interacting with each other and forming very ordered structures.
In other words, they assembled themselves.
And if you look at this model, what you see in the center are what we call the base pairs.
Hud's focus is the RNA molecule, a chemical sibling to the better known DNA. RNA does the genetic heavy lifting in a cell, translating the information stored in DNA into the materials that are needed to build a living organism. Some researchers believe that RNA, or an RNA-like polymer, was the first molecule of life. Hud's team works with chemicals that are believed to have been present on the early Earth.
So we can then look at this chemical inventory and we can select from it the molecules that might have been important for getting something like life kick-started.
So far, none of the labs working on chemical evolution has been able to coax actual RNA to self-assemble in the lab. But Hud and his team have identified a couple of molecules that make a structure that almost looks like RNA.
They start out by simply pairing together, then they stack together. They form structures that go from perhaps 2 to 6 molecules to 12 molecules until we get up to the level of thousands, even hundreds of thousands of molecules associated together.
Hud says these may well be some of the chemical ancestors of RNA as we know it today.
If we take the components that we have in RNA today, and we change them, sometimes just by 1 or 2 atoms, what we find is that they react together much more easily, and they seemingly put us on the road towards making what we might call a proto-RNA polymer.
Putting chemistry to work, sleuthing out the origins of life, a bit like genealogy perhaps, but going way, way back on the family tree. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.